Hi, I'm Charlie, and welcome to 7 Days Market.
We're going to be serving breakfast 7 days a week. Obviously, this is our bar over here. We're also going to be serving sushi at nighttime, sushi and steak. My family and I, we moved out here 5 years ago. My late brother Al, he actually found this place online. And originally, I was kind of skeptical at first because Johnsburg, no one's ever heard of Johnsburg, you know, especially maybe being from the city. I was kind of skeptical and saw a picture online, which wasn't so great. Had a picture of the siding and nothing with the water, you know. So my parents finally took me out here and immediately I fell in love with the water. From my knowledge, this building itself has been in existence since the early Prohibition days, I believe. It was originally called Nell's Ballroom around the early 1900s and eventually turned to Tomasello's and Raymond's Bowl in the 70s, I believe. We took all the bowling lanes because this place has been a bowling alley for quite some time, and we figured we cut out the strips and made some tables off it. And what I like about these tables is it's actually an extinct wood in North America, or actually in the whole world. It's longleaf pine. Obviously, they chopped it all down. You can't find it anywhere unless you find some bowling lanes. And yeah, these tables are all handmade by me and my dad. My mom went back and forth from Menards, getting all the tools and so forth. And yeah, it took us, I think this took me over like a year just doing all these tables itself, yeah. Well, 7 Days Market has to offer is for anyone and everyone in Johnsburg to come in, okay? It's like a public house. When we scoped out Johnsburg for the very first time, before we actually decided to purchase this place, we drove around and really, pretty much Johnsburg really doesn't have anything. It's a food desert. We got a few bars in town, but there's not really a restaurant where anyone could come in. Anyone under 21 or anyone, you know? So, 7 Days Market pretty much is a place for everyone and everyone to come by, try our foods. And, you know, we got great food, great staff, you know, great service, you know, great location. Obviously, we got right next to the water over here, really close to Pistakin Lake, you know. And quite frankly, I think this is probably the best place in Johnsburg to come to. Well, this building has a lot of different rooms. Over in the deli, we got a lot of different specialty sandwiches and a lot of hamburgers, a lot of different type of hamburgers and fries. And over here in this room in particular, we're going to be serving breakfast 7 days a week. Now when they say breakfast, the reason why we're doing breakfast is because the first thing that came out of the mouth of the mayor was, are you guys doing breakfast? You know, people just kept saying breakfast, breakfast, breakfast. And obviously, like I said, there's nothing in Johnsburg. And so that's what you want for us, the breakfast. And
We'll be open for breakfast 7 days a week. Sundays we open for champagne breakfast, and at nighttime we'll be open for some sushi and steak, Japanese cuisine, with a touch of American flair to it, you know. Whether you're 5 years old to you're 90 years old, it don't matter, you know. You could be wearing nice suits, or heck, you could be wearing shorts or whatever, you know. I want everyone in Johnsburg just coming here to feel like it's their home, you know, whether you have money or no money. I figure it's like, if you don't have any money, you might have money tomorrow. Your friends will have money. It's fine. You don't need any money to come in this place, you know. Our coffee is only going to be $1.50, $1.50. I mean, we want people to come in here and just relax and have a good time. Not very, we got some really nice specialty pancakes, and it's not just water and eggs and flour. There's a lot that goes to our pancakes. As you can see, we got a lot of different types of flours, corn flour, buttermilk flour, a lot of different sugars, all different sugars over here. Baker's special sugar, buttermilk flour, corn flour, cinnamon, all that stuff over here. You see right here is a recipe book that I've been working on for 5 years. 5 long years of working on. And a lot of our recipes were adopted from an old Danish recipe from the 40s, and I kind of took them up to our liking.
So it's just another place to play, you know, get musicians out here and keep kids out of trouble. One of the first things to go in schools is music and arts programs, because sports brings in so much more. So if that ever happens, you know, you can always come here. I'm going to have open mics once a week. So that'll be a little later, but for now we're just got kind of like a small local music fest for bands to get their names out. So, but it's gonna be good, clean, fun, guys. So that's basically it in a nutshell.
And as you can see, our walls are littered with a lot of history over here. I hooked up with a local historian in town. His name is Michael Clark. He was generous enough to hand me these pictures. This picture actually right here on Adams Grove Street, it's actually a picture of my house in the 40s. I actually lived right upstairs, actually in the back of the dry cleaners. Okay. All these pictures you see on the wall, the ads of like old vintage photos of pinup girls and cigarettes and so forth. I actually found a magazine underneath the bowling alley and they were cutting out the lanes, and they were inside a box, and I decided to cut up all the nice little bright advertisements and hang them up on the wall. Yeah. Over here I got some of my favorite people, Princess Diana. We got Michael Jackson from the baby. Welcome to Charlie Avenue. Obviously we're not open yet, as you can tell by the seats in the bar. Our bowling lanes, we used to make a bar. A lot of history on those bowling lanes. Chances are, if you're from Johnsburg, you might have dropped the ball in here. So, lanes 10, 9, and 8. Ever had the feeling that you was being had? Don't that that make you mad? They treat you like a slave, put chains all on your soul and put whips up on your back. They be lying through their teeth, hope you slip up off your path. I don't switch up, I just laugh, put my kicks up on their desk, unaffected by their threats, then get busy on their ass. This is somebody's mic.